In the next part of the first lecture of this module, now we want to talk about constant propagation. This will be a short lecture because we have looked at most features of constant propagation intuitively before in order to generalize our observations of bit vector frameworks. Here we now complete the story formally. So this is the example of constant propagation that we had seen before, and we have observed that starting with a top value, we could start with a bottom value at the entry as well. Starting with a top value, the MOP tells us that the value of C and D are 3 and 2 respectively here and here, whereas we compute MFP, in which we find that the values are really not what we expect. The values are different in MFP, they are weaker in MFP than in MOP. So this was the essential example that showed that MFP and MOP do not coincide or may not coincide for constant propagation. The component lattice for integer constant propagation looks like this. This represents the empty set and this represents the entire universal set. We used the notation Z earlier. I will change it in these slides. We should be using Z for the entire set of integers. And otherwise, we have just individual constants here in the middle. And this is a lattice that we have seen before, so we will not be spending too much of our time here. It's easy to see what the meat is. If along one path the value is top, then the value of the result is value same as the second argument. If in one argument the value is bottom, the result is bottom. The interesting case is only when one of the arguments is a constant value. So if the other argument is top, clearly the value remains the same constant value. If the other value is bottom, again this row gives entire bottom. The most interesting case is if C1 is equal to C2, then the result is C1, otherwise the result is bottom. Note that here we are showing a map from variables to values and we are showing it as a pair here. So in-out values are mappings. In-out are mappings in the set of all possible mappings var to L. Overall lattice is a set of mappings, which is all possible mappings from var to L. The meat operation, the overall meat and the component meat for one variable, and the partial order, overall partial order and component partial order for one variable, they get defined by each other. So partial order is restricted to data flow values of the same variables. Data flow values of different variables are incomparable. Meaning, if I have two maps, I will compare the values of the same variable in the two maps. I will not compare the value of A in my argument X with value of B in my argument Y. I will compare the value of A in my argument X with the value of only A in my argument Y. So we say that value of a given variable X, so we say X comma V1 is weaker than Y comma V2, where X and Y are variables and V1 and V2 are their values. If and only if X is equal to Y, meaning the variable X is same as variable Y. We are not saying the value of A1 is X is same as value of Y. This is not a programming statement. This is not a mathematical statement comparing the value. This is equality of the names of the variables. If X is same as Y and the value of X is weaker than value of Y. So the overall partial order is defined by point-wise or component-wise partial order over each variable. There's another notation that people often use, which says that X maps to V1, which is the value of X is V1. this is weaker than y maps to v2 provided x equal to y and v1 is weaker than v2. For meet operation, things become much simpler if we assume that x is a total function. What do we mean? This capital X. So, which means that this input-output in and out data flow variables, the values of these variables are total functions. Meaning, some value is defined for every variable. So, it's not that we have only values of A and B defined in one argument to the function and values of A, B, C, D defined in some other argument. If there are m variables, we assume that values of all variables exist, that's the meaning of saying that it's a total function. If there is no value of a variable, we just assume that its value is top. So partial functions are made total by using top value. This simplifies many things. Now we can say x meet y is just a set of pairs where each pair is x, comma, v1 component wise meet with v2 if we have x v1 in x and x v2 in y. How do we know that if we have some pair x, comma, some value in x, we are guaranteed to find another pair with x, some pair giving value of x for in this argument y. How do we guarantee that? We guarantee that by saying that x and y are total functions, meaning values are defined for every possible variable. So here, another way of writing x meet y is just this notation, which uses the map. So, x maps to v1 meet v2 if we have x maps to v1 in one argument and x maps to v2 in the other argument. I will leave it for you to convince yourself that this definition of meet indeed satisfies all the requirements that we want of a meet, which is this operation is commutative, associative, and idempotent. In order to write the flow functions of constant propagation, it becomes much easier if we use a different notation from the one that we have been using so far. So, given a mapping, which is a mapping from A to B, XA denotes the image of A. So this small a is a member of A. It XA denotes the image of A, meaning XA is in B. And X square brackets AV changes the image of A in X to V, which means that X square bracket AV is equal to X minus AU such that U is some value in V union AV, meaning if the value of A was U earlier, please remove that value and overwrite it with value of V. This is useful to model situations such as when we have a statement A is equal to 5, we want to say regardless of what was the value of A in the constant propagation data flow value reaching the entry, please overwrite it with 5 because our assignment is now x is equal to 5. Okay, so now we write the flow functions. We are using a different notation here. We are not using gen and kill. Instead, this is more conventional mathematical notation. So we say that at the start, we define boundary information to be, we say at the, if n is a start node, then the data flow value at the entry of n is bi, which is defined as a set of pairs y, comma top, y is in variable. Note that we could as well have used bottom here. In some places people have used bottom, in some places people have used top. So we will take it as input rather than as having fixed something. If there's a question on constant propagation, it will be specified whether the boundary information is defined in terms of top or in terms of bottom. Now, at the entry of node, if node n, if n is not the start node, then the value is computed by merging the values at the out of P and at the exit of P. And what is a merge? Merge is something that we have defined here. So that's how we merge the values. And out n is computed by applying the flow function fn to in of n, where fn of x is defined as follows. If n is a statement, y is equal to c, where y is a variable and c is a constant, then all that we do is the output is same as the input with a simple change that the data flow value of y is changed to c. If n is an input y statement, meaning we are reading the value of y from the input and y is a variable, then the output is same as the input except that the value of y is changed to 1. On the other hand, if statement n is y is equal to z, where y is a variable and z is also a variable, then the values in the output are computed like this. It only changes the value of y. And what is the new value of y? The new value of y happens to be the value of z in the input data flow value. So value of z is propagated to the value of y. Finally, if the statement is y is equal to e, some expression e, y is a variable and e is some expression, we need to evaluate that expression e using the data flow values in x, and whatever is the result of eval, that becomes the value of y. If none of these conditions is satisfied, then the output is same as the input x. So this covers all possible cases. Note that because the statement is y is equal to c, the value of y is changed. Because we are reading y, therefore the value of y is changed. Because we are assigning a value to y, therefore value of y is changed. Here again we are assigning a value to y, therefore the value of y is changed. Meaning any definition of y, whether the definition is by reading it from the input or by assigning the value of an expression, that it changes the value of that variable alone, values of other variables remain unchanged. Note that this is a non-separable problem, so therefore when we say y is equal to z, we need to read the value of z in order to compute the value of y. This did not happen in line variables analysis. We would complete the data flow equations after we write the eval function, which is easy. Eval function is defined as follows. We use an auxiliary function operand, which returns the operands of all operands of expressions. So we are evaluating expression E from the data flow values available in X, meaning expression E is evaluated in the environment X if there is an operand A such that it is a variable. So we take intersection of operands of E and variables. So if we have an operand of a variable A as an operand of E and XA is equal to bottom, meaning in the input the value of A is known to be bottom, at the entry of the node we know that the value of A is non-constant, so we know that no matter what the expression is, the result will also be non-constant. So eval ex computes the result bottom if any argument of the expression is bottom in the given input environment x. Similarly, if any variable in the argument is top, meaning it has not been defined yet, we have not seen a definition of this variable, It means that we really cannot evaluate this expression. We will have to wait until we find the value of the expression. So therefore, this expression evaluates bottom value. Now there are two more cases, which is a unary expression, and we are considering only minus, a unary minus. So if E is minus of A, which means that A is an operand of the expression and the operator of the expression is a unary minus, then we simply pick up the value of A in X and negate that value, and that becomes the result of this E. Finally, if E is A with some binary operator O plus, plus in a circle, then all we have to do is to pick up the values of the first operand A and the second operand A and apply the same operator to them. Note that when we reach this case, we have ruled out the possibility that A is bottom. If A were bottom, we would have been in this case. If B were bottom, this case would have met. If A were top, this case would have met. If B were top, this case would have met. And it's not a unary expression. So when we come here, we know for sure that both A and B are constant, and there is some operator operating on these constants, and therefore we can compute a constant value in the eval function. So this completes the data flow equations for constant propagation. Note that this is in a very different form. I encourage you to try and write data flow equations of, let's say, live variables analysis in this form. It will be very useful and you will understand many things. So I would leave you with some tutorial problems for constant propagation. Here is a funny program, but it's a legitimate program. Construct a CFG corresponding to this program and perform constant propagation. So in the first case, assume that boundary information is top, and in the other case, assume that the boundary information is bottom for all variables, and perform analysis and see what are the results of your analysis. Here is another instance of constant propagation, and again I will leave it for you to work this out. For simplicity, we have combined multiple statements in one basic block, but in general for non-separable frameworks, we consider a basic block to consist of a single statement, because we do not know how to combine the effect of multiple statements. We will talk about this in greater details in the fourth module. But the idea is that although the flow functions are composable, it is not easy for us to compute a closed form function and use it in our analysis. Mathematically, they are composable. So what we instead of composing the two statements and representing flow function as one single expression, we apply the flow functions independently to two statements. This is different from bit vector frameworks, where the effect of multiple statements, the flow functions of multiple statements, can be easily composed, and gen for a sequence of statements can be computed, and a kill for a sequence of statements can be computed. So it's easy for you to imagine difficulty in composing when you look at flow functions in this form. Try to stretch your imagination and see if one statement is y is equal to c, and the other statement is z is equal to something else, and the third statement is w equal to something else, how can we compute a closed form composition? Note that the composition exists, and we had used intuition to write down composition here. So this is a composition of flow function for four statements, but it is not always easily possible to do so for arbitrary collection of statements. So therefore, to simplify the matter, we will use a basic block with a single statement. So here is the result of constant propagation. I will leave this result with you. It's there in the slides and you can work it out and see if you also get the same result. You should contact your TA if you find something different, or if you are unable to understand why we are getting the values that we are getting. So this is the result of constant propagation. We find A is equal to 2, we have A is equal to 2, then that flows here, we get A is equal to 2 and D is equal to 3, and eventually we get C is equal to 6. So this is the result of constant propagation that we get. So here now we want to argue about monotonicity of constant propagation. We have seen constant propagation is non-distributive, but do we know it is monotonic? So the proof is actually very simple. We will prove it by doing case analysis on different cases of the function. Okay, it's easy to see that the proof obligation trivially follows for cases C1. So we want to say that if we have values x1 and x2, if x1 is weaker than x2, then fn of x1 is weaker than x2, weaker or equal to than x2. If the flow function always produces the same value, then regardless of the input values, the output values will be equal and therefore they are comparable. So therefore it trivially follows C1. Similarly, if the flow function always produces the bottom value, again the flow function is trivially monotonic. In fact, flow function is also distributive in these two cases. And in C5, this is identity function. So again, it is trivially monotonic because output fn of x1 is x1 and fn of x2 is x2, and we've already been given that x1 is weaker than x2, and therefore fn of x1 is weaker than fn of x2. So the proof obligation trivially follows for c1, c2 and c5. For case c3, there is something interesting. Case c3, if x1 is weaker than x2, then it automatically means that the value of z in x1 is weaker than value of z in x2. If that is the case, then we know the value of y in x1 output, in the output of this function, the value of y is fn of x1 is definitely weaker. So therefore, this case is also proved. Now we want to prove the case, fourth case. This requires us to argue that when x1 is weaker than x2, the value produced by the eval function is weaker in x1 is weaker than the value produced by eval function with the input value being capital x2. And it follows from the definition of eval. I will leave it for you to work it out. In case you are unable to see why it is the case, please do let me know. This is something that we have seen before. Constant propagation is non-distributive. It's now seen, the constant propagation is monotonic. Now we want to look at the distributivity, and we have seen this before. Along one path, we are getting value 1, 2. Along the other path, we are getting value 2, 1. If we were to merge the value after applying the flow functions, then we get these values. F applied to 1, 2, 3 and top gives us 1, 2, 3 and 2. And F applied to 2, 1, 3, 2 gives us 2, 1, 3, 2. And their merge gives us bottom, bottom and 3. On the other hand, if we were to merge the values before, if we were to merge x and y, which means that we apply f after merging these, so this 1 and this 2 gives us bottom, this 2 and this 1 gives us bottom, this 3 and this 3 gives us 3, this top and this 2 gives us 2. So therefore, we now compute this value a plus b, we compute bottom plus bottom, gives us bottom here, and we do bottom star bottom for D, that gives us bottom here. So if we were to apply flow function after merging the values, we get a value which is weaker than this. So we have seen an example where f of x meet y is not equal to fx meet fy. And because the constant propagation is monotonic, we know that constant propagation is non-distributive but is monotonic. We have seen this again explanation before, but let's repeat it quickly. Why is constant propagation non-distributive? So we end up getting all possible values. We've seen this in the discussion in module 2, but let's repeat it. So we might get a is equal to 1, a is equal to 2, b is equal to 1, b is equal to 2, and we are computing c is equal to a plus b. So we get these combinations. We might get a is equal to 1, b is equal to 2, so we get c is equal to 3, which is the expected value. We might get a is equal to 2, b is equal to 1. So a is equal to 2, b is equal to 1 along this path. So we once again get c is equal to a plus b, which is 3, which is the expected value. But because we are merging the values, what happens here is that we might get a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 1, which gives us c is equal to 2. Note that there is no such path. When a is 1, b is 2 and b is not 1. On the other hand, when b is 1, a is 2 and a is not 1. So this is a combination that we are getting because we are merging the data frame values. Similarly, we get another combination that tells us that c is equal to 4, and therefore our analysis says that different values of c are possible. This is because at the entry of this statement, we have merged the data flow values coming from here with the data flow values coming from here, and that leads to loss of information. There are a couple of more tutorial problems on constant propagation, just to imagine the complexity of constant propagation. The question here is, how many iterations do we need? And the answer is interesting. So in the second iteration, this value d is equal to 2. So in the first iteration, we discover d is equal to 2. In the second iteration, we compute in of n2 from out of n3. And then we compute out of n2. And then we compute out of n4. In of n4, then out of n4. And then we get in of n5. And then we get out of n5. So in the second iteration, this value of d equal to 2 flows to c equal to 2. Note the original statement was c is equal to d. So in the second iteration, this value 2 flows to c. In the third iteration, this value flows to b. The statement was b is equal to c. So this value flows to b. In the fourth iteration, this value flows to a. And then in the fifth iteration, this value flows to this program point n10. And in the sixth iteration, this value flows to n1 and thereby all remaining program points. So we need 6 iterations plus 1 iteration in order to discover that we have reached the fixed point. So every backage occurs only once in the path from N3 to N1 that goes via N5, N7, N9. So I will leave this explanation to you. Now I have changed the program slightly. In the earlier program, we had d equal to 2 here. And so this was the program, and d equal to 2 here, and we had c equal to d, b equal to c, and a equal to b. Now I have changed the order. I put d2 here in node n9 and a equal to b in node n3. So this is a new program, and I leave it for you to figure out how many iterations are required. If you are unable to get an explanation, please do talk to me. Tutorial problems are very, very important to ensure that you have understood the concept. Again, this is another explanation of the boundedness of constant propagation. We are talking about a data flow value at node N7, and we have this flow function. Here, for a change, now we are taking a meet with 1, a is equal to 1, and we compute f0 of top is equal to this, then we compute this, and then we compute this. So in 6 iterations we converge, and in the 7th iteration we discover convergence. So f star, the loop closure of top, is we need to apply f 6 times and merge it with its values. The moral of the story is that the data flow value of every variable could change twice. So it could be top, and from top it could become some value constant, and from that it could become bottom. Why so? Because recall that the constant propagation lattice is this. So data flow value could start from top and could become this, and then could become bottom. So there are two possible changes. The first change brings it from this level to this level, and the second change brings it from the middle level to the bottom level. So the data flow value of any variable can change at most twice, and that tells us why the loop boundedness closure is high. So the data flow value of every variable could change twice. In the worst case, only one change may happen in every step of a function application. So if there are n variables, which means that there are 2n changes that are possible, because every variable could change twice. And in one step, there can at most be one change, which means that 2n steps might be required. So maximum number of steps is 2 multiplied by the number of variables. And the boundedness parameter k is 2 into var plus 1. Then we know that the value is not changing any further. There is something called conditional constant propagation, which we have excluded from the course. The slides exist. In case you are curious, you can look at it and you can ask me, but this is not a part of the course. With that, we come to the end of the lecture on constant propagation. In the next lecture, we will talk about strongly like variables analysis.